In our last video, a few days ago, we reviewed the three Disney dining plan options, along with our discussion about the best parts or pros of the last dining plan that Merida and I personally experienced, the Deluxe Disney Dining Plan. As promised, here's the flip side of that video, the cons of the Disney Deluxe Dining Plan.
The number one con, all your meals are prepaid, which was also on our pro list. You get full sit-down meals three times daily with appetizers, drinks, including alcohol, your entree, and dessert. You're more likely to eat more food than usual, which can be a consideration for folks with diabetes and other food-oriented issues.
Number two, you feel like you have to order the priciest items in order to get the best value, which makes sense. That's a big pro of it as well. But you may not want to get those priciest items all the time. And I had that experience. I ate steak a few meals in a row until I just couldn't take it anymore, because if you look at the menu and there's a $60 steak versus a $22 fish, and you're trying to get the priciest items, you see what I mean.
Number three, tips are not included, so the tips are not prepaid. So you are buying a higher value meal, and even though the meal itself is paid, that raises the price that you're going to tip on your final total. So if you do 20% tip on a $200 meal, you're still paying $40 for your tip, you know, for every meal basically. It can add up.
Number four, it's hard to eat it all. Many times you're still full at your meal that you're about to eat from the previous meal. Basically, when we went on our last trip and did the deluxe dining plan, for several days, I felt like you feel like right after you finish the Thanksgiving meal.
Number five, the deluxe meal plan may not be the best value during Epcot food festivals. And it's not just food and wine anymore, and even food and wine is longer than ever. Flower and Garden Festival, Festival of the Arts, the Festival of the Holidays. And it's being said that the Epcot food booths are so popular that they may soon be year-round. And we were too full to enjoy food and wine booths on our last trip. We spent one evening running around trying to taste a few things before it closed because we were just so full all the time. And although you can use your snack credits to get those things, you're like too full to eat it.
Number six. Room for your favorite snacks? Many times you're too full with this meal plan for Dole Whips, etc. In all the times that I've ever been to Disney World, this was the one trip that I did not get a Mickey bar.
And it was very hot too. Number seven, your day is planned around eating. Your dining reservations may determine your park and your activity schedules, and can make park hopping, spontaneity, and family meltdowns harder.
Number eight, you will probably drink more alcohol. Now, obviously somebody's going laughing and snickering right now. That's a con. Well, it can be a con and it can be a pro. Since the best value to a deluxe meal plan is ordering the priciest items, and alcoholic beverages are the most expensive items, you'll find yourself drinking more alcohol. That might not be good if you have those food considerations, you're a diabetic, or you're one of the other people in a party that doesn't like it when Uncle Joe drinks too much.
Number nine, use it or lose it. Like any of the dining plans, the same with the deluxe dining plan. If you don't use your snack credits or your meal credits, you will lose it, and that is wasted money, and that is not the best value. Con number 10, potentially, when you're making your dining reservations, you need to actually check out each restaurant and each meal specifically, lunch or dinner generally. Some of them will take two of your meal credits for one meal, especially at the dinners, and those are usually on the signature restaurants, which are the higher end restaurants. And that can be a con because you have to plan, it's gonna eat up your meals. However, it can also end up being a pro because then you don't have to have as many reservations or as many meals. You could actually eat less, get that really nice experience for two credits. So you'd have to plan that so you don't either run out or end up with extra credits at the end.
Overall, we loved our Deluxe Disney Dining Plan experience. Please hit the like button if you would and tell your friends about us and stay tuned to our next video.
And subscribe to our channel and have a magical day.